Hi, my name is Vyom Dixit, and I'm a part of Azure Identity and Authentication team at Microsoft. As an admin, you may have seen issues where users would have approached your help desk teams or to you for help on new device registration with your Azure AD tenant, and the error related to device not getting registered on Azure AD. Also, as a part of your regular security audits and reporting, you would have seen multiple devices tagged onto a user over Azure AD. I'm here to help you with the steps in this video, which you can use and learn how easy it is to configure maximum number of devices per user on Azure Active Directory. Let's have a look at how the error would look like for the end user and for an admin, where you can go and check for this error. I have a Windows 10 configured and my user is trying to register the device on Azure AD. But he's getting this error which says device gap reached. Now, to verify this as an admin, I can go to application service logs in under Event Viewer, go to Microsoft, go to Windows, look for user device registration, admin, and this is where I have an error with event ID 204, and this says device gap reached. Now, let's go to portal.azure.com. Open Azure Active Directory. On the left-hand side, we have the Manage tab. Let's go to Devices. Under Devices, we have Device Settings. And this is where we have maximum number of devices per user. By default, the value, as you can see, is set to 50. So this is the place where you can manage the number of Azure AD joined and Azure AD registered devices on your tenant per user. You can change the same from the dropdown to the available numbers, 5, 10, 20, which is a recommended value by us at Microsoft, and also you can set it to 100. Also, we have an option where you can enter your value as per your organization security practices around user devices. You can choose custom and type the value of your choice. If you plan to put that value above 100, we recommend you go for unlimited, as we have a configuration which defaults at 200 if the value is set anything above 100. Also to note, this does not apply for Azure AD hybrid joint devices. Hope this video helped you with this configuration and making Azure AD more secure and easy to use. Thank you.